ॐ नमो भगवते वासुदेवाय। ॐ नमो भगवते वासुदेवाय। ॐ नमो भगवते वासुदेवाय। नारायणं नमस्कृत्य नरं चैव नरोत्तमं देवीं सरस्वतीं व्यासं ततो जयमुदीरयेत्। नष्टप्रायेषु भद्रेषु नित्यं भागवत सेवया भगवती उत्तमा श्लोके भक्तिर्भवति नैष्ठिकी। शृण्वतां स्वकथा कृष्णा पुण्यश्रवणकीर्तनः हृदयंतस्थभद्राणि विधुनोति सुहृत्सताम्।
So we I welcome all the devotees who have come here for Srimad Bhagavatam class. We are going to discuss 10.2.20. So please chant after me. Just once again. Krishna, Krishna. Where is that file?
तां वीक्ष्य कंसः प्रभया जितान्तराम्। तां वीक्ष्य कंसः प्रभया जितान्तराम्। विरोचयन्तीं भवनं शुचिस्मिताम्।
It's not bhavanam, it's bhavanam. Bhavanam means room, just like this is a bhavan, we are sitting here.
Virochayantim bhavanam shuchismitam. Aheshame pranaharo harir guham. Dhruvam shrito yanna pureyam idrishi.
Word meanings.
ताम
हर
देवकी
वीक्ष्य
आफ्टर सीइंग
कंस
हर
ब्रदर कंस
प्रभया
विद द एनहांसमेंट ऑफ हर ब्यूटी एंड इन्फ्लुएंस
अजितांतराम
बिकॉज ऑफ कीपिंग अजित द सुप्रीम पर्सनैलिटी ऑफ गॉड है विष्णु विद इन हरसेल्फ
विरोचयंतिम
इल्यूमिनेटिंग
भवनम
द होल एटमोस्फेयर ऑफ द हाउस
शुचिस्मिताम
स्माइलिंग एंड ब्रिलियंट
आह
सेट टू हिमसेल्फ
एषः
दिस सुप्रीम पर्सन
मे
माय
प्राण हर
हु विल किल मी
हर हे
लॉर्ड विष्णु
गुहाम
विद इन द वूम्ब ऑफ देवकी
ध्रुवम
सर्टेनली
श्रिता
हैज टेकन शेल्टर
यत
बिकॉज
न
वॉज नॉट
पुरा
फॉर्मरली
इयम
देवकी
इदृशी
लाइक दिस ट्रांसलेशन एंड पर्पट बाय हिज डिवाइन ग्रेस अभय चरणारविंद भक्तिवेदांत स्वामी श्रील प्रभुपाद की इच्छा है। ट्रांसलेशन बिकॉज द सुप्रीम पर्सनैलिटी ऑफ गॉड हेड वॉज विद इन हर वूम देवकी इल्यूमिनेटेड द एंटायर एटमोस्फेयर इन द प्लेस वेयर शी वॉज कन्फाइंड सींग हर जुबिलियंट प्योर एंड स्माइलिंग कंस अ थॉट The Supreme Personality of Godhead, Vishnu, who is now within her, will kill me. Devaki has never before looked so brilliant and jubilant. Purport, the Lord says in the Bhagavad Gita, Yada yada hi dharmasya glanir bhavati bharata, abhyutthanam adharmasya tadatmanam srijamyaham. Whenever and wherever there is a decline in religious practice, O descendant of Bharata, and a predominant rise of a religion, at that time I descend myself. In this age, at the present moment, there are inordinate discrepancies in the discharge of human duties. Human life is meant for God realization, but unfortunately the materialistic civilization is stressing only the senses of the body, not understanding the living force within the body. As clearly stated in the Bhagavad Gita, Dehino Asmin Yatha Dehe, within the body is the body's proprietor, the living force, which is more important. But human society has become so fallen that instead of understanding the living force within the body, people have become busy with external things. This is a discrepancy in human duties. Therefore, Krishna has taken birth or taken shelter within the womb of the Krishna consciousness movement. Men of Kansa's class therefore are very much afraid and are busy trying to stop this movement, especially in the Western countries. One politician has remarked that the Krishna consciousness movement is spreading like an epidemic, and that if not checked immediately, within 10 years it may capture governmental power. There is of course such potency in the Krishna consciousness movement as stated by authorities. Kali Kale Nama Rupe Krishna Avatara. In this age, Krishna has appeared in the Hare Krishna Mahamantra. The Krishna consciousness movement is spreading like wildfire all over the world, and it will go on doing so. Men who are like Kansa are very much afraid of the movement's progress and acceptance by the younger generation. But as Krishna could not be killed by Kansa, this movement cannot be checked by men of Kansa's class. The movement will go on increasing more and more, provided the leaders of the movement remain firmly Krishna conscious by following the regulative principles and the primary activities of chanting Hare Krishna mantra regularly. So this is what we have learned from Prabhupada's purport. Now we are going to revisit the shloka means look at the shloka again. It's called Singhavalokan, and try to understand the Sanskrit. And then again we'll gloss on what the commentary of Srila Prabhupada. Tam Viksha, seeing her. Viksha means seeing her. Acharyas have commented Sakshat Drishtva. He is seeing Devaki directly. There is no evidence required for the demon Kansa to notice the changes in Devaki. Kansa, you can understand this means Kansa. Prabhaya Ajitantaram. Ajit means Krishna, who is going to be conquered by anybody. And Prabhaya means the effulgence which was manifesting from the whole persona of Mother Devaki. Why it was like this? Because Ajitantaram, in her heart, the Lord has manifested now. The reason for special beauty of Mother Devaki was because Lord has manifested within her heart. Now you see, we should try to put ourselves in the situation of Mother Devaki, which we cannot. Her 6 sons have been killed in front of her. 7th son has been transferred somewhere. I don't know, she just thought that she had a miscarriage. So she had all the reasons to be sad. Not only sad, suffer miserably. But she is happy because Krishna has descended within her heart. I was discussing with the devotees today in the morning. We have our Japa talk. So I was discussing this point, how that is a little on a lighter vein, that suppose we have a very nice shoe, and there are stones outside, then we have no problem. But the stones are inside, then we have a big problem. So now you see how stony situation is there for her outside, in a prison. And actually it's a very disgraceful situation, because even Vasudev was bound on his feet with a shackle, just like animals are bound. It's a disgrace, isn't it? He was a king, basically. He was a king, and was bound like that by Kansa for years together. So here we see that even though she is in such a externally bad situation, very fearful situation, but because the Lord had manifested himself within her heart, she is a pure devotee, that's why she is completely, the word is Shuchi Smitam. Shuchi means, in the second line, the last one, Shuchi means pure. So she has a pure smile on her face. Now, what is the meaning of this Shuchi Smitam? It is difficult for us to understand, because we only smile when we get some material sense gratification. But the happiness of a transcendentalist, which he experienced internally in his heart, sukham atyantikam yattad buddhi grahyam atendriyam vetti yatra na chayvayam stitas chalati tatvatah. A spiritualist, when he begins to feel the transcendental bliss of Krishna consciousness, the smile which becomes manifested is a different smile from the smile which we experience in material world. So this is this kind of shuchi smitam. She was not feigning the smile. Feigning, you understand? She was not making a show of smiling. She could not help but smile because Krishna was within her heart. Now you say Krishna was always within her heart. Yes, Krishna is in everybody's heart. But he was manifesting his bliss within the heart of Mother Devaki. So that's why I say shuchi smitam. Shuchi means pure. This smile was not an artificial smile. Virochayantim bhavanam. Virochayantim means she was decorating by her effulgence the whole room. One person is decorating the whole room by herself. And there, I don't know whether there were bulbs, obviously there was no electricity at that time, and there were some lamps or not, but by her own effulgence she was manifesting and she was illuminating the whole room. Amazing. Now, aha means, in the third line, the first word, aha means Kansa has spoken. Now, whom he was speaking to himself. Don't we sometimes speak to ourselves? Most of the time, especially during japa. So we speak to ourselves, we have to do this, we have to do that, we have to do this and this and that and this and that. So now he's reflecting and saying, Esha. Esha means this Lord Vishnu. Is he seeing Vishnu? What is the answer? Is he seeing Vishnu? Again, is he seeing Vishnu right now? The third, he says, aha, Kansa said, Esha. Esha means he Vishnu. This Vishnu has appeared now. Is he seeing Vishnu? He is not seeing Vishnu. He is seeing the effulgence of Vishnu which is manifesting from the form of Mother Devaki. But he immediately guessed, now Devaki is having Vishnu inside. Me prana haro. He is going to take away my prana. Prana means my life force. And Hari, the acharyas explain it like this. Hari can also mean lion. So just like the lion takes away the life force of elephant, similarly Hari, who is now in the gufa, you know the lion stays in a cave, so just like a lion is staying within a cave and lion comes out of the cave and kills the elephant, similarly Krishna, who is referred here as Hari, is staying within the heart or womb of Mother Devaki, and he has understood now he is going to manifest himself and kill me. So who is the elephant? Kansa. And who is the lion? Krishna. Okay. Now, Dhruvam Sritaha Yan Naha Pureya Midrishi. Dhruvam, this is certain. Now he is fearful. This is for sure. Dhruvam means without any doubt. It cannot be adjusted. It cannot be counteracted. Surely my death is certain. Why? Because I have never seen Devaki effulgent like this. Na Pureyam Idrishi. Pureya means before. Pura means before. Iyam means Mother Devaki. I have never seen Devaki so happy, so effulgent like this. Certainly Lord Vishnu had come. Now something's amazing. Srila Prabhupada, now let us analyze Srila Prabhupada's commentary. One thing Srila Prabhupada very clearly opens is that whenever there is decline of dharma, Krishna manifests, not we manifest. Sometimes one devotee was mentioning that in some explanation, somebody was giving this explanation of yada yada hi dharmasya as, it's not that God comes. People like you and me, we descend when there is dharma ki glani. So, you ask that fellow, can you tell us what is dharma? What is the definition of dharma? Before you understand what is dharma glani, you should explain what is dharma. He does not even know dharma and he's thinking he's going to establish dharma. So this is how people are there, and to defeat such people, Lord descends. So anyways, the idea is, this shloka everybody knows, so I won't elaborate much on it. But the point is that dharma, whenever there is decline in dharma, Krishna is abhagya. He knows when the decline of religion is happening. And then Sarat, by his independence potency, he manifests himself. So you cannot say why Krishna is not manifesting. Krishna is manifested in the form of, what did Prabhupada said? In the form of the Hare Krishna mantra. Now, and then the purport, Srila Prabhupada very nicely mentions what is the soul and root cause of the problem of this materialistic civilization. They are considering the self or the body as a self. Now, what is the problem if I consider myself as the body? Because I want to enjoy, then what is the possibility of enjoying? Through the body. And how do I enjoy through the body? Through sense gratification. So that's what Srila Prabhupada is saying, that it has become so fallen that they don't understand that there's a living force in the body, which is moving the body. That is very difficult. And it's amazing, if Hare Krishna mantra did not work, so why the atheistic people are against the Hare Krishna movement? There are so many people who are practicing so many things. There is not much objection in the family members who are not devotees if the student or the kid does so many things. He may smoke cigarette, yeah, what to do, he's just smoking cigarettes. Or he may watch video games, what to do, the kid is like this. But if he's chanting Hare Krishna, they have a lot of objection, is it not? Why? Unless they are devotees. Why is like that? Because the effect of Hare Krishna is perceivable even by the demoniac mother and father or demoniac friends also. Just like the effect of Krishna consciousness was experienced by a 100% full grade demon like Kansa. So this is the potency of Krishna consciousness movement. And you might be thinking, at least I am thinking, Krishna came in the heart of Mother Devaki. How Krishna will manifest within my heart? Would you like to know that? I think some devotees know already.
Pravishta karna randhrena swanam bhava saroruham dhunoti shamalam krishna salilasya yathasharat.
Pravishta karna randhrena, Krishna through in the form of Kahari katha, Krishna katha, and Krishna nam, he enters through our ears. That's why we are supposed to hear Hare Krishna also when we chant, sometimes at least. And when we hear Hare Krishna, then Krishna sits on the lotus of our relationship with Him, Swanam Bhava Saroruham, and then He cleans, Dhunoti Shamalam Krishna, He cleans the place completely, and then Swanam Bhava Yasalilasya Yathasharat, just like in the autumn season, all the water reservoirs are clean, and then we can see through that. So this is a very important point, Prabhupada, why I am saying this, because Prabhupada very clearly quotes Chaitanya Charitamrita Adi Lila 17.22, that Krishna has manifested in the form of the holy name. Now why Krishna is not manifesting as a person directly? Because Kansa is not outside, Kansa is within our heart. We know that, Kaam, Krodh, Lobh, Moh, Mada, Matsarya, all these anarthas are there in the heart, which is like a demon. And they have to be killed. If the demon was outside, no problem. But because the demon is inside, like a terrorist, so Krishna has manifested in the form of a holy name. By chanting Hare Krishna mantra, this demon will be killed. Now, as the demon becomes killed, the devotee's devotional, the soul's original qualities begin to manifest. And that will be noticed by people. That's why it is very important for us to practice Krishna consciousness very strongly, so that people notice. People actually, they should notice that this person is happy, and they would then only our preaching will be effective. If I preach to people, my dear Prabhu or my dear sir, would you like to chant Hare Krishna? Why should I chant Hare Krishna? I have been miserable by chanting Hare Krishna, but I'm sure you will be happy. Will that preaching help? A very interesting example was given by His Holiness Niranjan Maharaj. He was in a flight. And one person suddenly started talking to him, telling about himself, and he was from West. Normally in West, you can't ask people, I don't know, I'm not from West, but I heard that you can't ask people's name and what they do. Like India, it's normal, you know, when they sit in a train, what is your name, aapke kitne bachche hain, how many kids you have, Indians talk like that. But in West, if you ask people immediately, you know, their name, or I think they feel objected, especially outside people. So then suddenly he started talking to Maharaj. Then he said, he was so ignorant. And then he said, my wife is like this, and I have so much money, but I have so much suffering, and this and that. Then finally he said, asked to Maharaj, do you have money? No, do you have wife? Maharaj said, no, we are not supposed to marry. I am a sannyasi, I cannot marry. Do you have bank balance? No, I don't have any bank balance. Do you have a home? No, I don't have any home. I stay wherever I go to temple like that. Then he was looking at him. You see, outside demoniac, maybe eater of a cow flesh, he's noticing Maharaj's happiness. Then he said, why I'm telling you everything about myself? Then Maharaj looked at him and said, I don't know why are you telling me all these things? Then he himself said, because I notice you're happy. Even all those things which I collected thinking that they will make me happy, I'm not happy. And you don't have any of those things and you're happy. Because you must understand, sukham atyantikam yatad buddhi grahyam atindriyam. When we control our senses, when we chant Hare Krishna, when our senses become purified, we directly experience the happiness of Krishna consciousness. Isn't it? And that outside people can know. I can remember, devotees were doing kirtan here. One person from India, some visitor came and he was just sitting right there where the camera is. And he was looking at them. Ye jeevan hai. This is life. This is life. He was seeing that the devotees are very happy doing this kirtan. It's natural. I was surprised. Janardhan Maharaj was doing kirtan around 6:30, 7 o'clock we had aarti. And I was just under this tamal tree and I was saying, okay, let me now go back to my ashram. And suddenly my relatives came from Lucknow. Suddenly it was amazing. And they came and they said, oh, what an energy. He just completely like meat eaters, gross sense gratifiers, but they could also experience, oh, what an energy like that. They can't understand anything else. So it's very important for us to have very good sadhana so that we become happy first of all. And when we become happy, then others will say, oh, these people are happy. Then they would like to buy our product, Hare Krishna Mantra. Shri Manchatana Mahaprabhu ki jai, Shri Shri Manchatana ki jai. Shri Shri Krishna Balaram, Shri Shri Radha Shyam Sundar ki jai. Okay. Because you must understand, everybody is looking for happiness. And everybody is cheating everybody by promising that you will be happy by this product. But it does not, you don't get that happiness. Now, so this is thing which we discussed. Now, how will we spread it? Srila Prabhupada is saying in the purport, it is spreading like a wildfire. Now we must question, is it really spreading like a wildfire now? So, and if you want to make it spread like wildfire, Srila Prabhupada is making very clear formula. If you have in your books or something, it's very clearly. The movement will go on increasing more and more, provided the leaders of the movement remain firmly Krishna consciousness by eating and sleeping nicely. Is that what Prabhupada says? By becoming firmly Krishna conscious by following the four regulative principles, not 3.5, not 3.95, not 3.955, not nothing like that. 4.0 means 4.0. Devotees are intelligent, they understand what is the meaning of 4.0. For everybody, for brahmachari and for grihasthas also. 4.0 is 4.0. Nobody wants to say such things. But I am not speaking here for money, and nobody speaks here for money, so we can speak the truth. 4.0 means 4.0, not 3.5, definitely not 2.5, 3.75, not 4.0. So if we become fully Krishna conscious by 4.5, because nowadays there is a concept that who can follow the fourth regulative principle, no illicit sex, and only association with the woman, with the wife for procreation. Who can do that in Kali Yuga? Then why did Prabhupada give? Prabhupada did not come in Satyuga. Rather, we should think even Hiranyakashipu was following the regulative principles when he was doing tapasya. Even Ravan was following the regulative principles. So we are so fallen. So if you think we are very fallen, then we should try to raise above it. And the primary activity of chanting Hare Krishna mantra regularly, not as a background activity, but a foreground activity. You understand what is background? Like in our background, this bell is also ringing and so many things are happening. But right now our foreground service right now is hearing Srimad Bhagavatam. Does it make sense? Obviously it is foreground for Krishna directly. But background, you understand? Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Ram, Hare Ram, Ram Ram, Hare Hare. That will also help us, but not really charge us, not really transform us to the effect that we can see ourselves. Please forgive me, but in these things I am a little bit heavy on these points. If we do background japa, we will get background results which will accrue behind our background, but it won't come to the foreground. Just like our pujari is now doing the seva in a foreground way to Gaur Nitai ji. He is not checking WhatsApp now. Is it? I can make sure this, the pujaris are not doing WhatsApp, isn't it? Have you ever seen a pujari in Mangal Aarti sleeping, doing Aarti? And we forget, Dvaparer Janer Vishnu Pancharatrestu Kevale Kalyug Tu Nama Matrena Pujyate Bhagwan Hari. Srila Prabhupada quotes Srila Madhvacharya. So we are worshipping Krishna when we are chanting Hare Krishna. So if the pujari is not sleeping, or if the pujari sleeps for doses for 1 minute, will you object or will you not object? During Mangal Aarti, where everybody is there to see Krishna. So now we take the advantage, anyhow Prabhuji, I am fallen, so I can continue to sleep. So Madhur Kadamni says very clearly, first is Sharirik Nishtha, second is Vachik Nishtha, normal cases, then Mansik Nishtha. First thing is I can at least sit down and chant, or at least and not talk while chanting. I know everybody may have a different opinion about this, but I am 100% fanatically convinced about this, that Hare Krishna mantra at least our 16 rounds should not be done as a background activity, should be done as an exclusive foreground activity. Why I am saying so many things? Srila Prabhupada says in Krishna book, I think it's chapter number 61, Krishna's daily activities. And very clearly Srila Prabhupada says, Krishna wakes up and then he goes to, he washes his face and then he meditates on himself, because Krishna is to be meditated upon himself. But then Prabhupada says, we don't have to meditate upon ourselves, which we are accustomed to do. I like to do this, I don't like to do this. But then if we very, you know, attentive and very focused way chant Hare Krishna in the early morning hours, we will feel a transcendental bliss and transcendental taste. We were talking about this. And then when we become happy, then we will become happy, then others will notice this point. So for our preaching to actually manifest like wildfire, we must individually become Krishna conscious. Very simple example, Prabhupada has used the word epidemic, and everybody knows which epidemic is going on now. Corona. And how Corona is spreading? How can I get Corona? No, I should not speak like this. How can one get Corona? Only if he meets a person who may be asymptomatically or symptomatically affected by Corona. Are you able to understand my point? Somebody may be manifesting the symptom of Corona, or somebody may be not manifesting the symptom of Corona, but both can affect another person. Do you agree? And the other person can be affected to the stage that he will be killed also. Agreed? There is no problem. So now I may not be fully manifesting the Krishna consciousness symptoms like prema and all that, but still I can infect others. Have I not been infected by people who have not achieved prema? Is it difficult to understand what I'm trying to say? Those devotees who brought to you in Krishna consciousness, have they achieved prema? They may be still struggling, but they have infected us. And by their mercy, why we are sitting now in Vrindavan. So it is in my heart that we should not wait for getting prema and then preach. We can be asymptomatic carriers of Karuna of Sriman Chaitanya Mahaprabhu. And in that way we help others and we help ourselves also. So this is what I'm trying to say here, that to the degree we become Krishna conscious by direct primary activity of Hare Krishna mantra, japa and kirtan, and hearing Srimad Bhagavatam, to that degree we become convinced, and to that degree we can influence others. His Holiness Sachinandan Maharaj was asked Srila Prabhupada, he was relating to the devotees, Prabhupada, how you are so much convinced and you can convince everybody? What did Srila Prabhupada say? He said, if you chant 16 rounds regularly and you follow the four regular principles, you will be naturally convinced, because you will experience Krishna consciousness. And then you can tell to others. I give an example. I was taking prasadam. So on that day they had made rajma sabji. Now, one devotee particularly has a disinclination for eating rajma sabji. He was sitting next to me. He was very senior to me. So now, I did not say anything to him. I just tasted it and I said, oh, it is so nice. Oh, this is very nice today. This is so nice. So when the server came next time, the devotee next to me, he said, give me a little bit also. I did not tell him to eat, just because I was tasting it. So it was really nice. So that preaching works. That is the whole point. So that's what we are saying, how it can be wildfire. Same thing, we have to take to, just like Corona has now spread into community level, community transmission, we have to take it to community transmission level. If we quarantine ourselves, understand, quarantine, if we close ourselves in the room and think we cannot spread the movement, or Hare Krishna should be only to myself, I am sorry, but then it will not be like a wildfire. Now you say, Prabhuji, now this is Corona time, is all locked up, how will I preach? No, Krishna's mercy is so much there. Now all the devotees know how to Zoom. Every devotee, I am seeing now, we have Bhagavad Gita channel in our ISKCON Vrindavan. Thousands of people, at least 1,000 views, 800 views. Normally, that many views we were not getting. So now everybody is learning. Even a devotee in a village knows how to use Zoom. So they are able to connect to the devotees. And before I go forward, I will like to share this secret which many devotees don't know also. You may have your congregation, very good. But I have felt when I was working in a job, it was so difficult to pick up the beads. Somehow it appeared that the beads were made of titanium, the most heavy material. It was very difficult to chant Hare Krishna mantra. But using Zoom, you can have your own groups and you can help the devotees come together and chant together. So even sitting in your room, you can help devotees chant 16 rounds. Actually, it works. Devotees have given me feedback. They could not sit for even one round, and I'm seeing them, they can sit for 2 hours non-stop. And obviously I have to sit also nicely. So once you preach to others, you are forced to behave, forced to perform better in the Hare Krishna mantra. I cannot check WhatsApp, everybody's video is on. This is a secret, devotees, this can lead our Hare Krishna mantra through community transmission level. If each and every devotee in his bhavanam, if he has the word bhavanam in his home, he becomes Krishna conscious, he will naturally influence more and more people. And I'm seeing it. So many times. I've been telling my preaching tactics to everybody. You know why? Because if you start and if you become successful, I get the credit. That's what Prithu Maharaj says. Anybody who does something, anybody who supports, and anybody who directs, they get the same benefit after death. So if I am chanting 16 rounds and if I want to chant 32 rounds in 2 hours, is it possible? Yes, I'll tell you. It's very possible. Can you chant 64 rounds in 1 hour? Yes. You help 3 devotees to chant 16 rounds. So 16 yours and 3 theirs, you have 64 rounds. I'm not speaking out of my own. Prithu Maharaj says that. And you want to chant 3 lakh, no problem. Preach to 11 people and then you have your 16 round is yours and 11 from their side and you have 3 lakh. And then you say, how many rounds you're chanting? I don't know, 16 I count and I don't know how much is getting into my account. It's a fact. I'm not telling you to inspire you. It's 4th canto, you take the instructions of Prithu Maharaj. He says this point. So if you help others, so it's so very easy, and if you have, I don't think it's so difficult now, Zoom at least for 45 minutes is free, you can help and preach like this. I'm telling to all the people who are on Zoom or anybody, please preach to people. Something had written of Srila Prabhupada's statement, if you preach to one person also, Krishna will save you. And this I have read in Srila Prabhupada's purport, beautiful. When a living entity takes to Krishna consciousness, Krishna considers it his personal victory. This is exact lines of Srila Prabhupada, very inspirational. So please, we should also bring the people and also maintain them. And this maintenance part, it seems to be neglected. Devotees have told me they were finishing their round at 11:30 in the night. Now they are completed 6:30, 7:30, even 5:30 in the morning. And they are very happy. So they are charging themselves like this. So I am just talking about how practically we can spread this Hare Krishna mantra sitting in our room like wildfire, even in this lockdown. And this will continue. Even afterward, this can be continued. You can give Gita class, you can give Bhagavatam class, so many things. Also, I have a group in Telegram called Japares, in which people every day report what time they are completing their rounds, and I also post. So in that way also everybody is uptight. It's not that, oh, I'm finishing my rounds at 9 p.m. or 8 p.m. No. And every devotee is being helped. So this is I'm sharing because I was reflecting on this point, how we can spread this Hare Krishna movement like wildfire. Now I go further. Srila Prabhupada just talked about this bodily concept of life. And something very interesting which I found in Madhya Leela, beautiful point. This is called the chain of Maya. Krishna nitya das jiva taha bhuli gela ei doshe maya tara galaye bandhila. The living entities, Madhya Leela 22.25, that Krishna, I am a servant of Krishna, that living entity has forgotten. And that's why, because of that only, the Maya has chained him from the neck. This is a garland, but Maya is not giving us a garland which we think. We think Maya is giving us a nice garland, this Krishna's garland, but she is actually putting a noose around her neck. And what is that? Just like an animal is pulled, even if the animal doesn't want to go there, he is pulled literally. Similarly, Maya is pulling the living entities into sense gratification. That is the Maya's chain. But then how it can be cut? The formula is given, Tate Krishna bhaje kare guru ra sevana Maya jale chute paya Krishna ra charan. So then, that's why now when a person begins to serve Krishna and serves the spiritual master, then he becomes Maya jale chute. He becomes free from the net of Maya, and he gains Krishna's feet. You may have heard this shloka, but can we imagine what benefit we can give to a person by helping them explain what is Krishna consciousness? How do I know that he will not become Krishna conscious? Suppose the person who helped me, suppose the person who preached me for the first time or gave me a book, and if he would have thought, nah, this is, he will not become devotee, then we would have not got any chance to become a devotee. So everybody should be given this chance, whether in home or wherever. Now Srila Prabhupada beautifully explains this. What is this Guru Sevan? What is the seva of the spiritual master? So he says that very beautifully. If by Krishna's mercy he gets in touch with a bona fide spiritual master, and we have all got in touch with Srila Prabhupada and their representatives, abides by his order, same, chanting Hare Krishna, following 4.0 regulative principles, and serves him, engaging, what is that service? Prabhupada very clearly explains, engaging other conditioned souls in the Lord's service. He then attains liberation and Lord Shri Krishna's shelter. Did you understand the point? Serves Krishna, you chant Hare Krishna, but what is Guru Seva? What is Guru's mission? Srila Prabhupada very clearly explains, engaging, helping other conditioned souls in Krishna consciousness. So for our own liberation also, it is very important that we should preach. Now again I am repeating, it doesn't mean necessarily means that you have to go out. Now we have the medium by which we can go out while remaining in. Make sense to you? If you don't want to leave Vrindavan, no problem, never leave Vrindavan. From here we can go to Yamuna directly, but we can spread the message all over the world. I was just sharing with devotees, if Srila Prabhupada would have had this Zoom and everything, what kind of preaching Prabhupada would have done, we cannot imagine. What kind of facility which we have now is amazing. You know, Prabhupada would have given like maybe 24 hours lecture or something like that. Everybody could hear. Just imagine if Prabhupada was with the Zoom japa, how many thousands of people would have joined to chant japa with Srila Prabhupada. What benefit they would have got, you know, and Prabhupada would have said, sit properly, like this. I again want to share one thing. When Mataji from Agra, she comes in our Zoom japa. So before she joined, I asked her, what time you are finishing your chanting? Yes, yes, Prabhuji, by 6:45 I am completing my chanting by 6:45. And in the Zoom I saw she was coming for a few days at 6:45. This is how people cheat. Then slowly she started to coming by 5:30 and 6, because then she said, oh, so many Mataji, so many Prabhuji, so many devotees are chanting so sincerely. Even initiated devotees are feeling inspired by new devotees. So everybody is enthused to chant Hare Krishna, not pay your rent japa, but actually pay your Krishna consciousness, whatever. It's not just a formality, they want to eagerly chant Hare Krishna. And we must, everybody's responsibility is, especially Prabhupada says Indians and everybody's, we should take it to community transmission level. I am thinking like that. Even in Indonesia, devotees have started doing that. Around 39 devotees were there. When I went there, I asked them, how many of you people chant 16 rounds? Some people raise hand, young people. And then say, how many of you chant before breakfast? It was such a big austerity for them. They never thought about it that you can chant 16 rounds before a breakfast. So anyhow, I'm happy that they have started doing that. So how the holy name cuts off this chain? So you understand this Maya's chain? This Maya's chain is this desire for sense gratification. This has been explained in Adi Lila 7.83.
कृष्ण नाम महामंत्र रेत स्वभाव जय जपेता तारा कृष्ण उपजाए भव.
ब्यूटिफुल श्लोका, अमेजिंग श्लोका बाय शिला ईश्वर परिपाद टू श्रीमन चैतन्य महाप्रभु. कृष्ण मंत्र, कृष्ण नाम महामंत्र एत स्वभाव, दिस इज द वेरी नेचर ऑफ महामंत्र. यू नो स्वभाव, स्वभाव इज सो डिफिकल्ट टू गिव अप, इजंट इट. वी आई हैव माई हार्ट स्वभाव, एवरीबडी हैज अ स्वभाव. सो वी से समटाइम्स डिवोटी सेज प्रभु जी वाई यू बिहेविंग लाइक दिस एंड दिस नो नो इज माई स्वभाव. सो वी कैनॉट गिव अप आर स्वभाव एंड कृष्णाज होली नेम कैनॉट गिव अप इट्स स्वभाव. एंड वट इज द स्वभाव ऑफ कृष्णा? जय जपे माता जी प्रभु जी, इलिटरेट लिटरेट एनीबडी, जय जपे तार कृष्ण उपजाए भाव. ही डेवलप्स भाव फॉर कृष्णा विच वॉज द ओरिजिनल कॉज. वी फॉर गॉट कृष्णा और वी आर फॉरगेटफुल ऑफ रिलेशनशिप विद द लॉर्ड एंड वी आर बाउंड बाई आर नेक बाई माया. सो वेन आर भाव फॉर द लॉर्ड और लव फॉर द लॉर्ड बिकम्स मैनिफेस्ट देन नेचुरली वी विल फ्री फ्रॉम माया. इट्स वेरी सिंपल. One devotee sent me a photo, it's very interesting. You know that one game the kids used to play like this? About, I don't know what it's called in English. Seesaw? Something like that? I don't know. Like this. So on one end is the tiny jiva, the other end is maya. So he's going like this, going up and up. Then he cries out to Krishna. Krishna comes from behind and Krishna jumps here and Maya goes off completely. So in our own strength, we cannot fight Maya. That's what Krishna says. Maya, what is that? Maya mitam tarantite. Those who take shelter of me, then Maya goes away. So that's how Maya has to be defeated. Now, I have already spread this, mentioned this point. The spread of the movement depends on how much we increase our viral load individually and collectively. You understand this point? Viral load? No, don't understand. Like this whole corona has called, how much virus is there in the body. Depending on that, a person can infect more and more people. So similarly, I'm not saying my words. Srila Prabhupada says, our members of Krishna consciousness movement should be so pure that even if a person unknowingly associates with them, he should be able to go to Vaikuntha. That is Prabhupada's instruction. I'm just telling you verbatim from Chaitanya Charitamrita. We should be so pure, not by our own strength, by chanting Hare Krishna and by following the regular principles. We should be so pure that unknowingly somebody comes in contact with the devotees, he should become infected. It may be just a matter of time. We have 10 minutes, so I'll just gloss something what the acharyas are saying about this shloka again. So one thing was that because the mother Devaki was having Lord within her womb, she was smiling out of genuine bliss. Shuchi means pure. Pure means genuine. It was no kapat, there was no deception within mother Devaki. Earlier she had smiled sometimes just to show to Kansa, I am not angry or like that. But now she is very, very blissful and that's why she is chanting, she is feeling very happy. Other things were mentioned. Okay. Now, in Brihad Vaishnav Toshni, Srila Sanatana Goswami Pad says that Kansa, the word Vikshya means Sakshat Drishtva. There is no need for Kansa to get evidence from anybody else. He could directly see the effulgence of Mother Devaki. And he gives a quotation from Vishnu Puran. Na sheke devakim drashtum kashchid api ati tejasa jajvalyamanam tam drishtva manansi shobhamayayuhu. Now we must understand this effulgence of Mother Devaki was not simply like we see some people are a little bit effulgent. But it was not like that. The word here is jajalyaman, it's like fire. He could not look at Mother Devaki. That's his mention, that because of her effulgence, nobody could look at Devaki. And seeing her shining form, his mind was disturbed. Why is it was disturbed? Because he was thinking Lord Vishnu is certainly within her. And now he says another meaning. He says a secondary meaning is like a snake. The Lord has taken shelter of whole out of fear of me, a lion. Now, another meaning of this Lord, this is Prana Haro Harim Guham. He takes a secondary meaning or is that just like a snake takes shelter of a hole. Similarly, Hari is taking shelter within the womb of Mother Devaki because I am like a lion. This is how he explains like that. I'll say something upon smile. We know that how devotees were very eager to work very hard, go out of their way to get a smile on Srila Prabhupada's face, is it not? We have heard so many times in Prabhupada's katha and like that. How can that be so much inspirational? Again, because Krishna tumara, Krishna ditepa. No, what is that? Govind tumara hridaya sada govinda vishram. That smile of Srila Prabhupada is not the smile of this world. A person can immediately understand that if Prabhupada is smiling, then Krishna is smiling. So that smile, being attracted or being inspired by the smile of Srila Prabhupada, so many devotees dedicated their life for Srila Prabhupada. That's amazing, isn't it? Another example of smile of Kardam Muni, when Mother Devahuti, when she was unmarried, was brought by her father in front of Kardam Muni. Then Kardam Muni and Manu Maharaj were having a discussion. And after that, Kardam Muni spoke something about the Lord, and then he became just silent. And just because, and then he began to meditate on Lord Vishnu within his heart, and the smile came on his face, very nicely described. And looking at the smile of Kardam Muni, Kardam Muni's external appearance was not good. But looking at the transcendental smile of Kardam Muni, Mother Devahuti was completely, surrendered, something like that. So you can understand this smile, genuine smile of spiritual happiness comes, it's a genuine smile, it doesn't come out of, just to show that how nicely my teeth are or something like that. That happiness, that smile is different from the deceptive smile of this world. I'll stop here and take up some questions are there or something. Maybe I did not go too fast or I don't want to make you wait for prasadam. Prabhuji has a question. Okay.
As you were speaking about, there are so many ways of preaching.
Yes.
So now, proper time there was nothing, that was preaching.
Yes.
But now it's more preaching there. And in future also we think that something better will come from what we are doing now.
Yes, so in the future if something will come, then we'll use it. I don't know, I'm not a technologist. I did not make Zoom, I'm using Zoom. So that's not, Prabhupada also, Sanak Sanatan Prabhu was telling me this point, how devotees were very intelligent. Prabhupada was using that dictaphone, isn't it, for translating. So Prabhupada also was using the technology at that time. It's nothing, I'm just saying if Prabhupada would have got what we have now, what an explosion would have happened. That's what I'm just saying. So we should use it. I don't know for what future. I can only the future that after 5 minutes I'll get prasadam, hopefully. Beyond that, I don't know. So I don't know what is going to happen in the future, but definitely Mahaprabhu's mercy is there, people, the holy name will spread. One thing is very nice, the Krishna consciousness movement will not spread because of me, but in spite of me. So even if I don't have any qualification, we can take shelter of Sriman Chaitanya Mahaprabhu. Krishnadas Kaviraj Goswami says, Bhakti Shastra Pravartaka. The most fallen person can, by the mercy of Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, become the Pravartaka of Bhakti Shastra. So we should not feel we are fallen. I mean, we are fallen, but Mahaprabhu is very merciful. That's what Jiva Goswami says. I am fallen, but Mahaprabhu, through this mercy, we can do so many things. Just like if the chammach in our Krishna hall, chammach, you understand, instrument by which we distribute prasad, falls down on the ground, is very fallen, what do we do? The Prabhu will pick up, clean it nicely, and again use it for serving prasad. Similarly, even if you are very fallen, Mahaprabhu is the Patit Pavan, he will purify us and engage us in preaching Krishna consciousness. That is the highest aspiration of a devotee, that he can be a preacher of Krishna consciousness. Naradji is in front of Lord Krishna directly and he says, what do you want? I want to eternally preach your glories in all the universes. We want to go back to Krishna and he's in front of Krishna. So there is no difference in mood. So whatever technology will come, we'll use. No, Yes.
So he had that faith. So similarly, we have that faith now. We are doing it, maybe after it will be much more doing.
Good.
Nice.
You should speak like this, because every time you say something positive, Krishna will hear and say, yes, yes, very nice. I heard from a devotee, one of the alwars in South India, he said that I can see the devotees chanting and dancing in the streets, and I give all my blessings to them. So like this. So okay, if there are any other questions, yes, Prabhu, Prabhuji, the mic to Prabhuji. Yes. Yeah.
Anything is possible.
And one. Badrinarayan Maharaj, His Holiness Badrinarayan Maharaj gives a very strong comment. Many times he spoke, he quoted Srila Prabhupada. Krishna can give you the whole world, but what will you do? Simply sleep. So the more we become qualified, the more Krishna will engage us in the service of preaching His glories. That should be our aspiration. And in that way, we ourselves become so much purified. Confirmed. So, you have a question? Last question we'll take, and then we'll... Yes, we can give the mic to Prabhuji. Thank you, Prabhuji, for your comment. And actually, we should have faith only on Krishna, because seeing our qualities, I have no faith on myself. But Krishna can get it done. Yes.
Thank you. Thank you for so, Prabhu, my question is that, as you said, there was sadhana should be more intact every time. So my question is that after maybe we try to keep our sadhana intact, but after some point of time, maybe 6 months, year, you know, the monotonous stage comes. So that time it is also said that you should increase your sadhana when you don't feel like also. But the point is that when you are not feeling or at all, you know, chant or read or whatever, hearing, so how one can try to do more and more in that case?
See, even if we can't do more, at least do what we are doing very nicely, and that will inspire us to do more. And if we have association of devotees who are struggling together, people don't know this. Maybe you don't know this. Vang matrena pujitam. Vang means vani, 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 vani. Vang matrena pujitam. Forget about mind. Can you remember this Sanskrit? Vang matrena pujitam. Very clearly. You chant. That's what Prabhupada says. Simply by chanting. Simply by chanting, the Lord is worshipped. What is the difficulty? But one thing is there. You help devotees. Maybe you can start your Zoom program and you help few devotees to chant Hare Krishna. So then you will have to perform. So what we do, in the morning we have a japa session, and in the evening for Kartik we have another 1 hour session. So those who want to chant more, they can come. This is open. So it's amazing, the experience which I get in morning is the same experience which I get in the evening. It's just because of association of those devotees who are eager to chant. If you drink in the morning or in the afternoon, it's same, isn't it? Prabhupada gives the example, keep on drinking the liquor till you become a drunkard. So like this, I have experienced now, I had this some kind of fever, I don't know what it was, and I had lost all my taste, and I was worried so much about this, why I'm not feeling any taste, what should I do? I just kept eating, and when the taste came, I did not even realize. Now you can come and see how much I eat nicely. So it naturally comes, isn't it? Another example is given by His Holiness Vrindavan Chandra Maharaj, beautiful example. I mean, I am not aware, but that's what he said, that just like a small kid, when he's on a mother's milk, he is not so much eager to eat food, but as he keeps on eating food, then he tells to mother, mother, cook this for me, cook this for me, cook this for me. Similarly, the taste for Krishna, not having taste is an artificial imposition. Taste for Krishna consciousness is natural. And it's my own experience, I may not have taste on a daily basis, but if I chant nicely, my taste for Shastra, for discussion of Krishna consciousness, for doing services increases. The taste for not immediately come. Also, those who are working outside, they don't get salary every day, yes? But they work for whole months. So if you chant for 1 month and if you have taste for 1 day, still we should chant. So we must remember this is our called Anartha Nivritti. If we do not do it regularly, we will not have taste. So keep on doing it, and Rupa Goswami Pad is saying, you will have taste. Okay, I'll finish on this point, last point which I heard from Jananivas Prabhu. Three things he told about having taste for Harinam. First thing is, you should have faith, the holy name is Krishna. It's not a material vibration. Should be chanted with lot of faith and reverence. Second is, we should be chanting attentively, trying to. And third is, we should not demand material benedictions. If these three things are there, then Krishna will reveal the taste with the holy names. So, you keep going. I am also struggling. Let us struggle together. Yes. Please forgive me. I just said last point. The conditioned souls are also very dear to Krishna. You know why? Because the eternal servants of Lord never had to struggle to get to Krishna. So, a struggle also is very dear to Krishna. So, keep on struggling. Okay? Srila Prabhupada ki jai, Srimad Bhagavatam Mahapuran ki jai, Shri Shri Harinam Prabhu ki jai.